faithfulness and the prayer that ought to be the Holy Spirit. And we move from a place here to a higher place, so we benefit from faith and faith to use the high faith. Okay? So this is your question. Question number two. What are the terms of faith? What is the place of exportative compared to the importative? They change their faith simply because the demand for both changes. So the intellectual places are different from the natural places. Where are they different? So then we can say that the domestic consumers were demanding them. No problem, because there are a lot of foreign consumers standing on a queue waiting for access to these goods that Norwegians cannot pay for because it's too expensive. So we reduce our consumption domestically because the price goes up. This leaves an amount available for trading. Who pays for it? Those who have more money, the top. Okay? So the terms of trade changes. Okay? And if it's minus 15, it's better than minus 2. So a few of this sounds a little bit strange, doesn't it? But it's the absolute value of the slope that counts. And if I say it's 2 larger than 15, not at least on a very low level, 2 is not larger than 15, is it? But if it is, then we have to restart all the lectures. 2 must be less than 15. I mean, if one of you are 2 years old, then you are younger than one who are 15, aren't you? Is that? Can I trust that you accept that law? Okay. So, after all that, if 15 is more than 2, and you will explain, but no longer over a glass of ananas. Now you want fresh fish soup made of the metal. Yeah. And the third is, there is a balance of faith, which means the value of export is equal to the value of import. So what you get from the export has to be exactly the sum of the deal. With this friend Daniel, since this is not an intertemporal model, this is static, given one time, you don't think about the future. So you use all the money, you pay for it, so it is a balance. Export values, you put import values, there is no profit. Okay? Time are getting a little bit shorter, but you are getting more and more bright, or brighter and brighter. I hope. So, in Model 6.3, we explain production, consumption, and trade. And there is a balance of trade. And the reason why it has shifted is simply because the terms of trade has changed the prices and then the profit. So, we move in this figure with all the lines from the point that the lead consumer includes with different prices. Where we consume differently than we can produce. That's about it. Food has moved. Look at it this way. The world is not standing still, it's in fact. Prices are changing. So that changes from a consumption into production to a production unequal or different from. Production, consumption. But remember one thing, you might be very good artists, but if you produce more than you consume of one good, make sure that you consume more than you produce of the other. You export the paper movement. yes, one good can produce more than you can see, of course. The other good can be produced in less than you can see. I thought my, probably somebody, are a little bit happier now than they were in the same time. Okay, thank you. So that is the standing model, explained. Pivot, high balance, and it's explained by consensus, point of taste, consumption, different from collection. What is the specific factor method? If you have a lot of time left on the 19th of May, you can write a few sentences about the other one, if you want to. If question 2 and 3 are not tricky than 1, make sure that you answer all the questions before you spend too much time. So, divide the number of hours with the number of questions, and let's say if you, let's make it this very difficult. You have 3 questions in 3 hours. How much hours do you spend on each question? Okay? If it's more tricky, let's say you have 4 questions in 3 hours. You can come up with the answer if you send me an email tomorrow, and I will put up some information. Okay? So, divide the time per question, and spend the time you have for each question. And if you have enough time at the end, you can do whatever you want to add to the answers. One small secret. We all write on paper. We have to put the number of pages in the front and the each page number. Okay? Let's say you have a show on page 3 and the answer of question 1 stands 3. Remember one thing. Get a new white blank page and start the next question. Why should we wait? It is because at the end, you come up with a very good idea that you have to do here. And then you have to put in an extra page. So instead of saying on page 3, look at page 9. This is 2, look how this is page 4, and all of a sudden this is 4, and then this is 2. So you don't have to add new sheets to read it. You turn to page 9 because it's only page 4. Instead of saying, don't put the number of pages to the end. Don't start the next answer of the question on one of the pages. Start in the next. 2 things to remember. You can manage 2. But don't paper for the next question. If you add the extra page, don't put pages number until 3 minutes before ending. You can, of course, do it 3 minutes before, but then you need a minute to put down the extra pages of the number. So here's getting a better grade because 3 minutes is the minute. Because in half, where you put in numbers, which is good. Okay? Thirdly, 2 things to remember. And if you don't remember, send me an email. I'll remind you. And if I get a lot of emails, I'm going to put it on content. Blank pages for new questions, don't put page number in to the end. So if you open up your front page and you open for math, after the celebration of the 17th of May, you won't see nothing, so it'll be even the 16th of May, instead of every week. Okay? Standard model, standard to build model, the Sierra one and the carbon one proves the day of the proof is strongest from carbon with all the knowledge from the set. But then it's more vague. Okay, I was a lovely place, wasn't it? At least I'm recording this, I can leave. Import is indirect production. Or put it another way, I don't get it to produce it myself. because I can buy it cheap for myself. We call those Chinese T-shirts in my country. And I think that one is produced by Vietnamese workers in southern China. I'm only female, and the age of all of them is below 29. You can see on the right side. So most of this is because it's cheaper to import it instead of producing it yourself, because it's cheaper. And then you say, you only import T-shirts, no, you import Italian cars. Now, because you are lazy, the trade can be at a lower cost than you. Have no reason why to produce a same cost and make a little cost. Yes. Do you know why you do not produce paper? No. The American authorities decided that American cars should be electrically driven. Where can I find an electrically driven car that I can produce one American car himself? And the answer is paint. Only a year and then a year. And they said, that is what you can do. Instead of producing it yourself, you can import it. But if the demand is high enough, and you are American, and you buy it, there is one essential question on page 143 that gives you the ISO value. It simply explains that the value of import is the value of export. So therefore, it is in the standard market. So both of you will not a very long and lasting memory. This is the ISO value. It explains that the value of export is the value of here it is. If you get 9 layers of it, just call it the ISO measure. You better study. Don't bother to put it all the whole equation. Just remember it is the ISO measure. It has to be in the figure. Simply because it splits consumption and production. That is the ISO measure. So if you need somebody in the street with an umbrella, pointing down like this, it's not the ISO value line, but it looks more or less like an umbrella. Negative slope is driven by export and import of goods in the ISO picture. Okay? Now, when it's snowing in Norway, you use the umbrella. You think in France that it is against rain, but it's not against snow. Okay? It looks like the ISO value line if they're not using it. Okay? This is, I think I said once, this is the only equation we need to remember. But after the 21st of May, you can forget it. And I will remind you of it in February 2017 when you come back to do it one thing. Okay, ready? And I will serve you fresh Norwegian fish food because we don't serve bacalao in public. We do it in the market. So that is the model. This is the same culture. This is what takes place because on this coast. They pay the most because they benefit from it. You can explain it in different theoretical analysis. Stick to the topic. So if you are in doubt on the 19th of May, it's standing money, it is relevant. Okay? If it's irrelevant, don't try to put it in to any questions. But you can have a short note at the end of that. But it's still related to standard money for the question. It's very fairly people ask for it, but only at the last page, the last sentence. Okay? Now he starts to discuss trade economic policy and concludes that if there is a growth in the economy, export bias growth tends to increase production and the if you confuse more than demand it, what happens to the country? It's based on the growth in export by production, this will be the bandit. Okay? So what you should do if you are Norwegian and wonder should I put my resources into technological improvement of oil and gas production or in car production for the answer is technological innovations in car production because in import. And one day you will have a version of Lamborghini that is Norwegian for half the price. And even better than the environment, just we will be selling much. And that is what includes the condition of the outcome for the nation. If you want growth, thinking that it is in the import orientation. Even in the Delta. You still import German cars, although you are technology, will include the Italian Maserati or Lamborghini. So still you will buy German cars from Delta. But the only resources to improve our import value growth. Because you get more of the resources, you get more money for our export. And we reduce the cost of it because we can do it cheap to new Malaysian technology. So that is conclusion number one. Relative price of course, we pay less for import. Either we import more or it's more valuable to produce more. What is the economy of scale? Simply, large production reduces the unit cost per produced unit. Is this beneficial to the world? Conclusion answer is because it reduces the cost of production, it improves the condition for trade, and trade is to all countries in the okay? Yeah. So if there are economy of scale, let them produce this because this will be the cost of trade and then. What we call economy of scale could be what we call clusters, which simply means the letter in the thinking formula. Silicon Valley syndrome. Network, which simply means there are links between anything producing the same goods, and they can utilize the same resources, same technology, the same logistics, policies, etc. Labor market pooling, which simply means good ship builders live in the same land, not working in the same firm, but in the same industry, but in the same knowledge. We call it labor market pool. They should be collected in the same area. So if one of them is fixed for a year, I just cut over to a neighbor and say, you have one pool in, let me have yours for a year. That is it. Okay? No knowledge spillover. We haven't seen it, have you? But I can show it to you if you come with me to your son. You will see knowledge spillover. It simply means that there are a firm, a small firm, that produce equipment for a ship. This ship is produced at 1 yard. But in the other yard, 50 yards away from that yard, that was the level of equipment. There are a need for the same knowledge. Not exactly the same, but getting access to that knowledge and can put it into my production and it means the cost of the instead of knowledge spillover. It could mean, especially like a Norwegian student finishing international economics in Molde, could move to a place where they have no knowledge of international economics, so they produce a lot of things that could be exported. And when you come back in 2017, she is the richest Norwegian woman because she did the knowledge spinning. Got the patent rights for it, and is now producing not Arnold Schwarzenegger movies, but Bill Clinton movies. It's different. Okay? You haven't heard of it. Not yet. But before you know, there will be in effect all the cinema. Don't look at it if you ask me, but it's mine. Okay? There is also a precursor effect. It is not paid now, but it can be paid in the future. One of them is what we call industry concentration. And then we are back to the t-shirt. Why are there so many t-shirt producers in China? It's simply because that is a potential point for China. And now we speak about the 1990s. If you look around, are there any Chinese t-shirts available by trade? No, by now, 10 years later, or 50. Have you seen any? Yes, so the potential trade in the 90s is actually paid 10 years later, when we start to produce two Chinese t-shirts. No one knew in 1990 that this would be a big business. It's potential. Now we know the answer. Are there any t-shirt imports from China to Norway? I check mine. Probably it's produced in Sweden because it's a very old one. Don't tell anyone. Okay? So then we end up with the single location problem that we discussed when we discussed Vietnamese production contra Chinese production. The Vietnamese production could be cheaper or less costly, but it still is producing Chinese because they started first. Is this beneficial to the world? And I'm afraid the answer is yes. Because it increases income. Either less costly labor or more advanced technology. Do you know any place in Norway where they have advanced technology? Where they can use. What do they use them for? It's not even 80% of it is exported. So if you wonder if there is a Norwegian vessel in North Shore Saxon in Brazil, can you say the answer is? Maybe in Brazil? In the US, let's say in the Gulf, Mexican Gulf? Off the coast of India? Off the coast of Vietnam? Not until the Chinese have removed their war vessels, but then they will be. Yes. So that is what we call advanced technology that are needed and it's produced here because no one else has come up with the idea yet. And then we look at them at science forces. And then I would answer, think. Think was an electrical power produced here. A big example of the Kimberley something. Very expensive car. Have you seen it? I think it's produced in Eastern Norway. It's about 8 or 9 of them. Guess if they are lucrative and expensive. Do you think they are cheap? No. So, technology advances can produce commissions for most of them. Okay? When we are into the Chicago LA, and if you want to suggest that I have seen the Arnold Schwarzenegger movie, I will bring you to my family and we will have a long discussion over the food. Okay? That is perfect. And I will pay for the flat here, if you need it. Thank you. Thank you. 10, not 12, but just 4, but good to be consistent. Okay? Here we go. Remember, turn your face. Turn your face. To love you. And you should all probably speak in tongues. Why do they speak Polish in your tongues? It's because maybe not in tongues. The forces are then not the major source of production. Spirit is anything that's more important. And it has to be very near, because it has to be fresh, but then something. I can give you an example. If you have a headache on the 18th at night, some of the reason you should have it. If they need medicine, there are three medicines in Tanzania. How many Norwegians do you think of the 98% of men would go to Tanzania to buy the key person? And you have a very bad health person. And why would you fly to Tanzania with the bad health? I don't know the answer. But the answer is, I need it now. I need it here. I have fresh medicine. So that explains why faith is a minor part of the nation or the practice to come. Okay? There are very good fish in Norway. So when the rain comes back to France, you can still remember fresh fish from Norway. But do you think you will fly to Norway to fish and then go back to make a fish dish in France? The answer is, I need it fresh. Okay, if you are in Japan, you go to a sushi bar, you can get it fresh. But it's far from France, isn't it? So just fresh goods you need immediately. You cannot wait for it. Okay? That is what it's saying, the gravity. When you wake up, remember that the gravity moment is about fresh. You are getting closer to your job, so that 20 minutes. You remember the reason why the timely production of the research is done is simply because they started first. If you wonder why the German car production is so dominant in Europe, it's because they came up with the idea. I think it was 1886. One was Daimler, the other one was Benz. Now they call it the Daimler Benz because one did not survive to the war of Europe. So if you are looking for a very good Finnish car, they are going to learn because they dominate car production in Europe. They have tires in Finland. They call it Nokia or Katolika. And now no one in Finland is buying back a Katolika because if they want something from Nokia, they competing with something and information. Okay? So, when you are in business, you can keep many others out of business by being different. And when we are into tariffs and subsidies. And this idea of tariffs is to influence trade. The effect of tariffs is that import is more expensive. Export subsidy means that export is more important to sell. Then, they influence prices, both home and foreign. If it goes away, if you are a small country, tariff is not worth it. If you are a big or a huge economy, it can be very hard to sell. Why is it hard to sell? It's simply because of what we call distorting effects and even deteriorating effects. The last one simply means to destroy everything. Distort means that you shift the possibility to distort. To distort is simply means that resources are gone. Whereas, can it be picked up, let's say, in a nearby jungle. Because they are laying there waiting to make a plan. The story simply means that you can't shoot them. If you destroy it. So some kind of panic effect is simply waiting to collect it. Okay? The current effect we find is unclear. And if you will be the secretary of the Italian Minister of Trade, and he leads you off as what I call a nice little bar outside nothing, yeah? Don't accept it. Export subsidies is only helping. Why is he leading you at a bar and not yet to something because the son of a godfather and there is the biggest factory in your exporting country. So he will earn a lot of money, but don't tell him. Okay? This yes. This one, before and after, you think there is a change also with relative demand, this one. So the idea is, one, you raise the influence of the supply and demand. So this is having an equal effect. Once you both demand, it's trying to explain what happens to the influence both at the same time. Which simply means that the relative price of one stock is the same amount. So don't do so. I won't ask about it on the 19th of May. But if you run into a problem and you come back to France, for example, it will simply indicate that you can have similar effects on both, and then the only effect is simply change that the and you can see this for 7 months. Because both demand and supply is in place. Then, okay? Because what we focus on is simply the effect of the cost. The price goes up. In this market, there is a huge or big economy, so you can influence also the price. But the effect of trade is part of the subject less resources because the surplus or the profit of the firm is usually produced because it's produced at home, so then, two, the consumer has to reduce their consumption. And that is a loss of consumption. So, yes, trade will be affected. We shift from buying it cheaply, from abroad, producing at home, and this cost us. So, it's a loss of the surface for the producer. Instead of home producers, you have home producers. They are more costly. This is a surplus for foreign production. What happens to consumption is it has to be reduced. The price has gone up. This value is what we call consumer surplus. So this is value for the consumer. It means you no longer can buy, let's say, forex. So forex. This is forex. This is forex. Then it's more costly to do something because of less consumers. So that consumer loss, producer. This is the income for the government. So the town gives the government more money. But at the expense of producers and customers. So the value for the production of this good. With a higher domestic crisis. Gives the public sector money that it costs we need to study. So it costs because international production is less profitable, home consumption is more expensive, less than that. This is not earned by it, so they can introduce it, consumers will pay for it. Why do they do it? Why do we do a trade policy? We can do it. Or get more money. So yes, they want to support the local market. At the same time, they also want more money. So yes, they can sell this as ordinary for production. Or if they sell it even, buy business. But it's more expensive and less efficient. But at the same time, it's not. So what is the local production? But if you ask me, should I have more Norwegian cars? I'm not convinced I'm selling them less. So I lose money from it. But they can get a Norwegian car. Then tell them that it will stop around the next bend. Because it's not normal to be reached. So yes, we get more information. What's more, what is it? We pay as a consumer. We pay as a producer. The government is happy because they get money. So that is normally a situation. So why do these consumers accept that the government is more money? How many governments are there in the country? One. How many consumers are there in the country? So probably to start when it's over. 1 million? 2 million? 15 million? 200 million? How can you organize 200 million to protest against one? It's like having a German team playing football against a Spanish team. Have no chance at all. Do the score at all. And this one team beats them. So yes, one government can outrun whatever protesters there will be because there are so many. And one of them is living in Los Angeles. Another one is in Chicago. A third one is in New York. They might probably meet one day. That is accidental. So yes, there are so many influence. But it's a country interest. You cannot pay for the ticket from Los Angeles to Washington to protest. Half a dollar extra. It happens. We would say if you are for example. So that is the answer. This is trade policy governed by one against the interest of millions. And if you want to know the answer, ask the top up in the German. Why didn't it work out? There are distortions of production, there are distortions of consumption, both are lessons. But we deteriorate resources because we cannot gain them or regain them. They are gone. That was the cost of over, as Pat would say in the boardroom after 90 minutes of humiliation from Spanish type, which is not Spanish at all. Because one is Portuguese and one is from former Yugoslav. I think at least one is Brazil. So if you ask me, don't do what they do in Paris, France, and not buy a Swedish player that is either Portuguese or Brazil. The next time you qualify at least for the second. So that is what it is about. There is a coalition. One against all the others. but it has no but incentive to grow it because it leaves so small in service. In addition to the carrots, export factories, you can have private factories, you can have public ownership. But if I ask you on the 19th of May, what is a red tape barrier? You know what a red tape is? Have you seen one? Very often, where there are nervous around it, it's rather white. So it's more or less like that. You are not allowed into if you are not entering the right point. So red tape simply means you are allowed, I think this was done in Russia, to stay this spot or location. If you come on a Monday before 8 o'clock, and only in February the 1st, and what you realize is February 1st is a Tuesday. What happened at 8 o'clock the Monday morning? The office opened at 9. That is a red tape day. It's almost impossible to get there, to import to that market. And to give us an example, I think in those days when we left here about it, it was about the Russian female underwear, with 6% cotton, which was demanded. And how many German underwear producers put 6% cotton into their exported collection? I haven't seen any yet. Simply because it's extra cost, it's not worthwhile, it's a solid investment. Maybe they earn to take extra, but it's more budget to sell it to Swedish female consumers because they pay that much. And that is Europe. So that is a red tape barrier. It's almost impossible to get into the market. It makes it impossible to sell it to the market. But some argue, although some say that it is a domestic market failure, so you have to correct it. Or some say it has a marginal social benefit. The first one is nonsense. It's better to use domestic policy to correct domestic policy. It's a waste of money to use health policy to correct domestic health because you don't have to do that. But there might be social benefit about changing a number when domestic. Okay? So if you ask children, you also think if there are impossible to meet the first best solution, it is domestic issues to get started. Because that is focused. Okay? If you are supported or protected within economies, and for all of us that we've been through, you've become protected. Three, how many of you have US produced T-shirts on you right now? None. Why do they protect it? They want the American consumers to buy American clothing. Why should they buy American clothing when they can get the cheaper version from China for a better quality? It is better for American consumers to buy the cheaper version from China. And yeah. If you ask me, do they, what they do in Istanbul, do not start to produce T-shirts because no one will buy it from Chinese shirts. What do they do in Istanbul is selling high tech or other industrial goods. They're going to market for exports. What they're trying to do is a boycott. Better to support activities that can create a benefit. So, yes, we are the local version of it. you have American cars producing Detroit. What is happening to Detroit right now? It's decaying. People are moving away. I think the city is empty. It's hard to stop the effects of COVID. You can do it for the short term, you can do it for the longer term, you can do it for the more costly. And it's better to do it for other effects. Okay? Then let's do that. The point of comparative advantage was used for the infant in this realm. Okay? It's not necessarily correct. Two, if you have an abundant structure, it may not be there for the whole world period. Occupy it can shift. So if you look at what's happening in Israel, it used to produce gold for fishing. I think you can still buy your gold for fishing in Israel, but it's cheaper than you get larger number of observers. And you can fish from the west across the coast, so you want to fish in the big boat. So, yes, there might be an abundant factor, but you don't think that you start to grow, and then what do you need to do? The strongest argument is simply this: no one knows the future. But if you know the future, keep it to yourself and start to use the people that will be contributing to you. So, yes. One try to support industry. Who would think, and since we are here in the flesh, in 1975, in Nokia in Finland, that in 1995 there will be no power production in this plant? In this plant, we're going to produce cell phones. And somebody looking at cell phones, what is cell phone? Yeah, I know that it in radio. There was a guy in New York who produced a cell phone. One guy, guess how many times he was safe? If you go back to Finland, 20 years later, 1985, are they still producing tires? Not many. Are they producing cell phones? Maybe one of the biggest producers in the world. So no one knows the future. That's the problem. There are a basic list of free trade items. I think you are able to read them. And now I'm united. Probably one of the best ways to start is to call domestic production. It might end up in trade. If you ask me what are the major problems, and that we can discuss in 2017, when the Italian economy is going better. One is income inequality. And the other one, the biggest one, is coming up. If you want to develop, people need to be working. Why do they need to be working? They need money. They need an income. Okay? We have the emission effect. It has not been the unlimited growth change. Perfect substitution is not the answer. It's better to increase output. If you are moving to a developing country, probably you are before you know, simply because there is where your firm will be operating from now. World welcomes more nations. There are room for new entrants. It can be triggered by different instruments. Not one answer. So all of them can help the opportunity. If you ask, we have them, what is important is improved trade conditions, diversified countries, and e-partners, because the friends are now eating species that came from your heart. It's better to have a variety. Of cultural effects. Why? It increases the cases of consumers being moved up on the welfare level. When we are almost at the end, aren't we? Yeah. Environment, we have discussed lately. Old Testament, okay? Growth strategies, there's not a single one. But probably, when we need next time, all of you drive an electrical car called a solar panel car all the way from Germany, even though it is snowing in London, because it is on the map. For the end. If you want to know the answer of question three, turn the pages. There they are. So, answering question three, which is the last question you will answer if there are any questions. So, simply remember, figure, A, no, what was the number? You find them in the chapter on monetary policy. So, the link between monetary and exchange rate is simply interest. Okay? Then it is almost 3 minutes past 13. See you on the 19th of May, because I usually drop by to see you select and throw bottles against me. But have a nice weekend. See you on the football game tonight, no more or less. And if you have any questions, email.
Can be boosted by your sporting company.
to save them from being suppressed. Since they do the same, they have to come from the same group.